A reflection acting on the coordinate plane takes point G to point H, point G to point H, and point S to point T, point S to point T. What is the line of reflection? So the line of reflection is going to look something like, it's going to look something like that. And it's going to go through the midpoints of H and G, which is going to be someplace over there, and the midpoint of S and T, which is going to look is going to be someplace over there. And I'm drawing it very imprecisely. And the way we think about it, when we take the reflection of G over this line, you would drop a perpendicular and then go the same distance on the other side to get to point H. Similarly, I can never say that word, if we were to take the reflection of S around that line, we would drop a perpendicular to that midpoint and then keep going the same distance to T. So let's think about what these midpoints are. And actually, I'll clear this right now just so that I can draw it a little bit more precisely. So let's clear that. And so H is at the point 2, negative 2, 2, negative 2. G is at the point negative 2, comma, negative 6. So what's the midpoint? Well, the midpoint is going to be the midpoint of the x-coordinates. 2 plus negative 2 is 0 over 2 is 0. So the x-coordinate is going to be 0. The y-coordinate, the average of negative 2 and negative 6 is negative 4. So our midpoint is going to be right over here. It's the point 0, negative 4. Now let's think about the midpoint of these two points. S is at the point 1.5 comma 5.5, and T is at the point negative 9.5 comma negative 5.5. So the midpoint is going to be 1.5 plus negative 9.5 over 2. That's the x coordinate. I just took the average of these two x coordinates. And the y coordinate is going to be 5.5 plus negative 5.5 over 2. So what is this? This is 1.5 plus negative 9.5 is negative 8 over 2. So that is negative 4, comma 0. So their midpoint is at the point negative 4, comma 0. So that point right over there. So we essentially, so let me just write this. This is negative 4, comma 0. So the line of reflection is going to be the line that goes through both of these points. Is the line that goes through both of these points. And we can write it in the traditional slope-intercept form, y is equal to mx plus b. So let's figure out its slope. Let's figure out the slope between these two points. To go from negative 4, comma 0 to 0, negative 4. Well, every time to go between those two points, our change in y, actually, let me do this in a different color, just to ease the monotony. So our change in y over here is negative 4. As we go from this point to that point, we go 4 down. And our change in x is equal to positive 4. So m, which is our change in y over change in x, we see that when we increased our x by 4, our y went down by 4. So the slope is negative 1. And let's think about what the y-intercept is. Well, we already know that. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to b. But we see over here that this point is there. So when x is equal to 0, y is negative 4. So this is negative 4. So the equation of our line of reflection is y is equal to negative 1x, or I could just write negative x minus 4. That's our line of reflection. Now they ask us, what are the coordinates of the image of point negative 2 comma negative 2 under this reflection? So the point negative 2 comma negative 2, let me do that in blue, negative 2 comma negative 2, that's this point right over here. That sits on the line of reflection. When x is equal to negative 2, negative negative 2 is positive 2 minus 4 is negative 2. This sits on this line of reflection. So the coordinates of the image of this point under the reflection, well, it's just going to map back to itself. It's going to be negative 2, comma, negative 2. Anything that's on the line of reflection, when you reflect it across that line, since it sits on that line, it's just going to map back to itself.